Hello everybody, I'm Mr. Shinxy, and this is my Banjo-Kazooie walkthrough, episode whatever. In the last episode, we was in the middle of Rusty Bucket Bay, and in this episode, we're hopefully going to finish it. Here, I finally got to where I wanted to, after falling in the water god knows how many times. That was where the last Jinjo was, just to give you a... Oh yeah, and it's the Tall 8, just to give you a reference of where I am. If you get up there, using the jump pad, which is to the right of it, and press that button, the TNT drops down. And, because TNT can't magically fly back up and repair itself, you don't have a time limit. Which is good, because I don't think I'd be able to make it if we did. Actually, I probably would. Shortcut... It doesn't even damage you. See? Doesn't damage you. Now, you can use eggs to defeat this boss. That's why there's so many eggs around it. But it takes a long time to... Who dares enter boss boom boxes hold? I've hidden my jigsaw, so you'll never get it. I prefer just pecking it. It gets a nut. This is the actual only real boss other than Gruntilda in the game. I mean, I know a couple of episodes ago... Well, a couple of worlds ago, I referenced several normal enemies to being the bosses of the world, but this is the one of the only real bosses in the game, other than Gruntilda herself, of course. I say, just peck them. You can do normal attacks and everything, and eggs, it takes so many eggs to do, but eggs are the easier option, considering the room's surrounded in eggs. I prefer to just peck them, though. So you see, it's still not took out, and that needed two pecks, even after all them eggs. So just don't use it. That middle-sized one it was either two or three pecks. These tiny ones only need one, but I suggest rolling into them because they're too small, really. So yeah, there you go, boss defeated. Ah, you splintered me. Take this. I didn't want it really. I don't know why, but I imagine him having the voice of that really strong, the actor in The Simpsons, the really strong one who's always in the movies with white hair and such, and talks strangely. Don't know why, but I always think I always reference that boss to having that sort of voice. Anyway, defeat that boss. Boss, get the jiggy and eggs if you need it, and come on out with the conveniently placed stairs there, or ladder. Don't know why there would be a ladder there, considering Boss Boom Box, or whatever it was called, can't use it. But still, oh, I'm forgetting one of the most important places in the game. Can't believe I'm doing that. I was almost falling off then. Okay, that's the enemy of them two, and I still got hurt by it, despite knowing that that was the one which the enemy was on. Rare flag. Always great to see rare. Shame they had to almost disband, really, because of the Xbox thing. Anyway, in this mini-ship is a Mumbo's token, and, well, easy to get, really. And in this periscope, or whatever it's called, I think it's called a periscope, is this gremlin. Yeah. Never mind. Four notes here, if I can get them all without... I was about to say without falling off, but never mind. Hit that, and the fans slow down. I assume the pipes stop as well, because I'm looking at my guide, and it's saying there's three Mumbo's tokens to get, and you have to stop the engine for all of them. Actually, no, correct that. It's only two of them that you need to stop the engine for, and I'm hoping that basically does stop the engine, because that's kind of where we're going next. Okay, sorry about that, I'm not going there just yet, actually. I've forgotten this room, and that them periscopes, I can't say that word for some reason, them periscopes there. Okay, so destroy that enemy, because that's the one which will really bug you if you let it run around. Now, green bed, my favourite colour, green. Oh yeah, there's a feather on each of these beds. It's a real feather pillow. Pillow made of feathers. Now I'm not good at jokes. Anyway, if you go on here, female squirrel. We'll get into that in the next world. because it's actually it's probably going to be near, really near the end of the game, as in last few episodes, because it's the late part of the game. It's the later part of the world which you get to see her. Okay, them two beds, nothing special. This one, nothing special. Now, I was leaving this one to the last because I know something's up here. And that's why they put an enemy here on this bed. It should make you suspicious, but still. Mumbo's token right here. Well, it's a long time since I've done a close-up of a Mumbo's token. That's strange. Oh, we've got 36. And the next transformation doesn't need that many, really. That's actually good. Anyway, now the periscopes don't get hit by that thing. I'm just going to check these windows, see if they need to be smashed. No, they do not. Oh. Sun camera change. Oh. I love these windows. I don't know why, I just do. And I can't believe these are normally the last notes I get, purely because I go around the outside first. Yeah, they could be some people's first. So, it just depends on how you go around this level. Oh, 6 minutes into the video. That's quite good. Okay, go all the way over here. Actually, I don't... Ow. Okay, don't go all over there, all well over there, and then just do that. Okay, that's the first time I think I've actually just ran into one of them using a invincibility feathers. Okay, eggs on the first one, feathers on the second one, and notes on the... If you jump from that second one, you're likely to hit that pipe somehow. Okay, and on the third one are notes, of course. So now I've got 88. Okay, that's good. Getting better, getting better. Now, jump over here. You can't see it unless you go into first person. But there's a golden feather. And now, it's time for the dreaded engine room. I hate, and I exclamate that, hate this world because of this room. That's the only reason I hate this world. Seriously, that's it. Now, destroy that enemy. And if you want to, this enemy as well. You need to destroy it if you're gonna rush, and you need to rush. Now, I normally just jump and either die and just use this help, or don't get hurt at all like that, and just flap down. Alright. Wait. Oh, I've just realised something. In the last episode, when I was on the top of the chimney, Oh, I've already got this empty honey comb. Oh, never mind. I was about to say I looked at a different world bio, but I didn't. I got that empty honeycomb last video. Well, not last video, but when I first entered this world. That's what I was waiting for. I expected that to happen, so don't just rush into it. There's a Mumbo's token right at the end of that. Oh, I can actually mark that off my list then. I thought I couldn't mark off the list, but I can. Okay. Oh, no, they're not stopped. Oh, no, wait, it's them over there, isn't it? I'm going to get all the notes just so I'm safe, because Oh, no, they're not stopped. Oh, never mind. I think I know how to do it. I think I know. Please, I'm right. I'm just going to get the notes just so I don't end up dying stupidly. Because this room is a death pit. Literally. If it showed all the dead carcasses of Banjo, like in Call of Duty or something, it would be massive. Well, actually, that's just an endless pit, so you wouldn't see the carcasses anyway. But, anyway. Wait for these to stop. I have never gone across when they're just slowing down, because I just don't risk it. And 96. I am being extremely careful here. This is the most careful I'll be in the whole game, because this room's just got a bad reputation with me. It really has. This room just hates me. And these fans are the worst, especially considering you need to go across at least one fan to get them notes. When it's slowing down, jump just before the gap reaches you. It'd be so terrible if I fell off right now. Oh, thank goodness. That sounds so great, bottle speaking. You found all the notes in this world, well done. And then right at the back of that room is a Jiggy. And the ninth Jiggy. Now, I'm about to start almost like a quest, really. But it's only for one Jiggy, so it's not really a quest. Nothing across there. Don't bother going across there. Nothing. Now, I believe this is what it means by stop the engines first. It either means one of them or two of them. I'm going to stop both of them just to make sure. Now, what is it? Yeah, it's this one. Okay. So what I did there, I jumped just before the fan reached the gap. I only just be able to do it, but that's the safest way. And it does take some practice, so make sure you either go in this world and just do it before you get any notes, or make sure you've got all the notes before you start practicing, because it just does not work out. If you get so many notes and then find out you need to get, and if you've got like 90 and then find out you've got to get loads more. Oh, this is what it meant by stop the fans. I mean, stop the engine. Oh, they're so good. I hope I do not die, even though it wouldn't really matter right about now. I still hope I don't die. Come on. Oh yeah, don't worry about the time in the corner, that's for the Jiggy. I'm just worrying about the Mumbo's tokens right now. And that Jiggy I'll get into the next world, into the next... Oh, thank goodness, these are stopped. For some reason, my vision just went blurry then, and I was sure it just started going while I was on it, and my heart missed the beat just then. You really do not know how scary this world is for me, or this room, because I've died that many times in it. Anyway, this is the only way to get these, because I tried going across it when, just without the engine stopped, and, well, I died. And that was what you saw a couple of episodes ago. Anyway, I'm going to end this video off here, because it's kind of at a point where if you get the next, if you slam both the fans off and do what I'm going to do next episode, which is basically get the Jiggy, it's going to take quite a while. So I'm going to save it for the next episode just so I don't run out of time and not realise. Okay? So, after getting those really hard Mumbo's tokens, which I've never got before in my life, I bid you all farewell.